Senate will come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise and repeat with me the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
In the absence of clergy, may we please bow our heads in a moment of silence. Reading of the journal.
In Senate Monday, January 30th, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Sunday, January 29th, was read and approved. On motion, Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions. Messages from the Assembly. Excuse me. Secretary will read.
On page 7, Senator Klein moved to discharge from the Committee on Rules Assembly Bill number 377 as substituted for the identical Senate Bill 1068, third reading calendar 22.
Substitution ordered. Messages from the governor, reports of standing committees, reports of select committees, communications and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Mr. Floor Leader.
Yes, I move to adopt the resolution calendar with the exception of numbers 387, 487, and 370.
All in favor of adopting resolution calendar with the exception of resolutions 387, 487, and 370, signify by saying aye. Opposed, nay. The resolution calendar is adopted.
Would you please take up now the non-controversial reading of the calendar?
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 22 by member of the Assembly, Dinowitz. Assembly print 377, enact amending executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this act should take effect on the same date and same manner as the chapter laws of 2016.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Ayes 45.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 31 by Senator Amador, Senate print 894, enact amend the highway law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Ayes 46.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 45 by Senator Ort, Senate print 723, enact amend the environmental and conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 60th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 45, nays 1. Senator Serrano recorded the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 49 by Senator Croce, Senate print 939, act amend the civil service law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 90th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Ayes 46.
Bless you. Bill is passed.
Calendar number 52 by Senator Robach, Senate print 1011, enact amend the education law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Ayes 46.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 53 by Senator Carlucci, Senate print 1724, enact amend the real property tax law.
Read the last section.
Section 6, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Ayes 48.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 64 by Senator Golan, Senate print 227, enact amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 90th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Relation to calendar 64, those recorded the negative are Senators Montgomery, Parker, and Peralta. Ayes 45, nays 3.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 65 by Senator Ort, Senate print 258, enact amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Ayes 46, nays 2. Senators Montgomery and Parker recorded the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 66 by Senator Robach, Senate print 297, enact amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Ayes 48.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 73 by Senator Kennedy, Senate Print 671, an act to amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Ayes 50.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 77 by Senator Avella, Senate Print 1302, an act to amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Ayes 49, nays 1. Senator Montgomery recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 78 by Senator Golden, Senate Print 1741, an act to amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Ayes 48, nays 2. Senators Montgomery and Parker recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 82 by Senator Lanza, Senate Print 2616, an act to amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect on the 30th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Flanagan, Klein, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results?
Ayes 50.
Bill is passed. Mr. Floor Leader, that completes the non-controversial reading of the calendar.
Thank you. Can we now take up resolution number 248? It was previously adopted. Please read the short title only and then call on Senators Tedesco and Marchione.
The Secretary will read.
Legislative resolution number 248 by Senator Tedesco, congratulating the Shenandoah High field hockey team and head coach Gene Frivola upon the occasion of capturing the Class A New York State Public High School Athletic Association Field Hockey Championship.
Senator Tedesco.
Thank you, Mr. President, and my colleagues. Mr. President, up in the balcony above you there is an unprecedented, outstanding group of young ladies and their coaches. And we're very proud, myself and Senator Marchione, to be able to represent the Shenandoah High School and School District. It's great when a school wins one championship in a Class A area, goes through their entire schedule, wins their league, wins their section, and then goes on to win the Class A. But this is the second time in 4 years, and we're very proud of Gene Frivola, the coach, and her assistant coaches, and all these outstanding student athletes. They not only won all those areas, but they were 21-0. Did not lose a game, and to have two state championships in a matter of 4 years is really unprecedented. But I'm not surprised, because every year Shenandoah puts out excellent academic opportunities for kids over there, but activities and athletic opportunities. One championship after another championship after another championship, and they are certainly a championship school, and these are championship young ladies and coaches, and I'm very proud that we were able to pass this resolution, which we gave them a copy of unanimously, and they won that championship, I guess, 2-1 from a Scarsdale High School, I think that was, and that was in Enwell, and I guess all's well that ends well for Shenandoah and the girls' varsity field hockey team. So we're very, very proud of you, extremely proud of you. We'll probably see you back next year or in the next couple of years with another championship. And I would yield to my colleague, Senator Marchione, who I'm sure is equally as proud of you. And thank you so much, and welcome here to the Capitol in these august Senate chambers. And congratulations.
Thank you, Senator Tedesco. Senator Marchione.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Senator Tedesco. I am honored to be able to recognize the Shenandoah hockey team. And I was talking to the girls earlier, and I told them that I'm a graduate of Shenandoah High School as well. What I didn't tell them is I used to play on the field hockey team when I was there also, but I didn't play like you play. I was not anywhere near where we undefeated. It is amazing to be undefeated. And you know, when that happens, it should be celebrated and it should be honored. And that's what we're doing here for you today. Your accomplishment was just incredible. And it's a perfect end to a perfect season when you're 21-0. You certainly made your parents proud, your friends, your Shenandoah School District, and all of us alumni who were there rooting for you. Congratulations to you and your coaches, to your parents, an incredible win, a perfect end to a perfect season. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Marchione. To the coach, to the assistant coach, to the student athletes, on behalf of the New York State Senate, we welcome you. Congratulations, and we extend all the courtesies of the House. Madam Floor Leader.
Can we take up resolution number 387 by Senator Ort? Read the title only and call on Senator Ort to speak.
Madam Floor Leader, I believe that Senator Todisco would like to open the resolution up for co-sponsorship. So if you don't wish to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk. Madam Floor Leader.
Take up Senator Ort's resolution, please.
Yes, ma'am. The Secretary will read.
Legislative resolution number 387 by Senator Ort, commending Catholic Charities of New York State upon the occasion of celebrating their 100th anniversary.
Senator Ort.
Thank you, Mr. President. I want to rise to briefly recognize and certainly celebrate the 100th anniversary of Catholic Charities here in New York. I think about on this chamber, we certainly have passionate discussions and debates on the role of government, what government can do, what government should do. But I think we all recognize there are limitations on how much government can do. And very often it is groups like Catholic Charities, and Catholic Charities specifically, that have filled that gap where government is unable to go or sometimes unwilling to go. I think about all the working poor that have been benefited and helped by Catholic Charities. I think about all the single mothers, all the children that have benefited from the work of Catholic Charities. And I know firsthand in my district and across New York State that our communities have been better because of the work of Catholic Charities. And I know it's also maybe in vogue at a time when it's a lot more popular to talk about secularization and move away from religious themed organizations. But if you look at the work of what Catholic Charities does, the actual, where the rubber meets the road, and the work that they do in our communities and in our state, it is absolutely beyond debate that they have made New York State and our local communities a better place to live. And what they do and their message is a message I think we could all benefit from just in our own lives. So, Mr. President, I want to congratulate Catholic Charities on 100 years of great work in New York and certainly to 100 years more. And I thank my colleagues for their sponsorship.
Thank you, Senator Ort. Senator Kennedy.
Thank you, Mr. President. I too rise to congratulate Catholic Charities on 100 years of serving our community and on serving the most vulnerable individuals in society, those individuals that need a helping hand at a certain point in their lives, that but for Catholic Charities might find themselves in extreme and dire situations, more so than they are already in. Last year alone, Catholic Charities helped over 16,000 children, over 100,000 individuals in Erie County alone. There are millions of individuals across Western New York and across this great state and nation that Catholic Charities has helped over the course of the last century, and their work continues. And maybe now so, their work is needed more than ever before. With the growing income gap, with income inequality, and unfortunately, with the rich getting richer, and the poor getting poorer, there's more of a need now for us to help our fellow man than ever before. And so with Catholic Charities stepping up and being a force for good in all of society, we owe that organization and the leadership a tremendous debt of gratitude for their work over the years. And I'm proud to stand here in support of all of the initiatives and all of the work that they have done, and here's to 100 years more. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Kennedy. The question is on the resolution. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted. Madam Floor Leader.
Senator Ort would like to open this up for co-sponsorship.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. If you do not wish to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk. Madam Floor Leader.
Can we take up resolution number 487 by Senator Hoylman? Read the title only and call on Senator Stavisky first and then Senator Hoylman to speak.
Secretary will read.
Legislative resolution number 487 by Senator Hoylman, commemorating International Holocaust Remembrance Day on January 27, 2017.
Senator Stavisky.
Thank you, Mr. President, and thank you, Senator Hoylman, for being the prime sponsor of this resolution. If my great-great-grandparents had not left Germany, I would be one of the 6 million people who perished in the Holocaust. Fortunately, we are teaching about the Holocaust in our public schools, and people are reminded day in and day out that this was not only a tragic moment of our history, but one that can reoccur. There are people who deny it ever occurred, the Holocaust deniers, and they've become more and more active on the internet because it's so easy to post information on the internet and to recruit members for their organizations. And I think the person who really summed up the tragedies of what occurred was the Nobel Prize winner, Elie Wiesel, who passed away last year in July, I believe. He said, "The opposite of love is not hate, it's indifference. The opposite of beauty is not ugliness, it's indifference. The opposite of faith is not heresy, it's indifference. And the opposite of life is not death, but indifference between life and death." And in his Nobel Prize speech, he said, "I swore never to be silent whenever and wherever human beings endure suffering and humiliation. We must always take sides. Neutrality helps the oppressor, never the victim. Silence encourages the tormentor, never the tormented." And I think today those words are as appropriate as they were in 1986. So let us remember the victims, but also the message of what occurred. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Stavisky. Senator Hoylman.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Senator Stavisky, for those moving words. I rise to speak on the resolution commemorating International Holocaust Remembrance Day, which was January 27th. And I think most people know it commemorates the genocide that resulted in the death of 6 million Jewish people, 200,000 Romani people, 250,000 mentally and physically disabled people, and 9,000 gay men by the Nazi regime and its collaborator. Now, it was created, International Holocaust Remembrance Day, in 2005 because of a series of disturbing trends. First, there are fewer and fewer people, of course, with personal accounts of the Holocaust. But stepping into that gap of memory have been bigots of all kind across the world. They've spread lies and debased the memories of those millions of individuals who were murdered during the Holocaust. In addition, let's face it, there is state-sponsored anti-Semitism in countries like Iran. But in Western nations, and even in our own, there are many individuals and organizations who deny the reality of the Holocaust. And that's just not, you know, the KKK and neo-Nazis and far right-wing political movements, but more recently, the so-called alt-right, the white nationalists, who claim that the Holocaust is exaggerated or worse, never even happened. That's why I have to say that President Trump's statement on January 27th, commemorating Holocaust Remembrance Day, was so shocking. While it called out the suffering of innocents, as well as the heroism of those who took personal risks to save others, and it expressed a commitment to make sure that such an evil never took place again, the statement lacked one key fact: that the horror befell the Jewish people. And also, it must be added that the president's statement on Holocaust Remembrance Day was the same day that he issued his infamous Muslim immigration ban. The same day that he said that Muslims, individuals from seven predominantly Muslim countries, are no longer admitted to the United States of America. Well, we can help correct that today, Mr. President. You know, about 23,000 survivors are still alive in New York and will be up to around 2025. There's one in my district, which I wish to mention, a woman, she's 92 years old, named Gina Zuckerman, and she drew attention recently because she was walking to her senior center where she volunteers on a daily basis, and she was attacked by a mugger who tried to steal her pocketbook. And you know what Gina did? She fought back. The mugger ran away without Gina's purse. She's the kind of survivor, I think, that represents the best of New York City. And I'm very honored to represent her here in the State Senate. Before I close, though, I'd like to read a few words written by the president of the Anti-Defamation League, Jonathan Greenblatt. He said that the suffering of the Jewish people is not an afterthought, a prepositional phrase to be bolted onto the end of a sentence. The suffering of the Jewish people is the whole reason that the concept of the Holocaust was defined. It became shorthand to explain the unexplainable, the inconceivable, an intentional transnational campaign to exterminate an entire people perpetrated in broad daylight in front of the entire world. He goes on to say, we now live more than 70 years removed from these horrors. The global population of survivors is dwindling. At the same time, Holocaust deniers on the extreme right or the radical left seem to be enjoying a renaissance. And this comes at the same time that the Anti-Defamation League's global survey on anti-Semitism has found that 35% of people worldwide do not know of the Holocaust, and 28% believe it never happened. Over the weekend, as protests grew about President Trump's immigration ban, there was a Twitter feed called the St. Louis Manifest that released the names of passengers on the St. Louis, which was a ship filled with Jewish refugees turned away from the United States in 1939. The ship's 937 German Jewish refugees were returned to Europe, and 254 of the passengers were later murdered in the Holocaust. So today, we remember those refugees on the St. Louis. We remember the 600 million who were murdered. We stand for our sisters and brothers. I stand for my husband, my daughter, and their family. And we say, never again. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Hoylman, Senator Squadron.
And first of all, I thank Senator Hoylman for putting this resolution in and for his moving words on it. To be clear, Holocaust Remembrance Day exists to make sure that we remember that we never forget the horrors of the Holocaust, but also the origins and the reasons for the Holocaust. To be very clear, it was built in a fascist nationalism and a goal to exterminate the Jewish people from the face of the earth. To ignore that is to deny that. To deny that is to erase it. So we have to ask why, at a time and a moment when, as a country and a world, we should be recommitting ourselves to the eternal memory of the 6 million, so that we can prevent any horror against any people of that scale in the future, our president would choose to erase the suffering and the murder of Jews from this day. Now, my mother-in-law was born in a displaced persons camp in Germany after World War II. Both of her parents had survived the camps. Her father, his entire life, carried the tattooed number on his arm. She, along with her parents, was allowed into this country from the displaced persons camp in order to find refuge and a home here. She and her siblings, raised in public housing outside Philadelphia, she raised my wife, her sister, truly living the American dream. And today, my children, her grandchildren, are descendants of that history of extermination and survival and refuge granted by this country. Why would we want to deny that, or ignore that, or erase that? The only possible reason could be for the very reason Holocaust Remembrance Day exists in the first place, for the very reason generations of school children, whatever their faith, wherever they live, have been told, never forget. Because there are those in this country who know that if we forget, if we erase, it is that much easier to head down the road, the very dangerous, very evil, deeply un-American road that got this world there in the first place. Holocaust Remembrance Day, I'd like to honor all those who were murdered in the Shoah, all those whose families, friends and loved ones and communities were destroyed. I'd like to honor all those in this country and around the world of all faiths who in the years since have stood up against fascism and intolerance, have stood up and taken on the cause of avoiding such a tragedy in the future. And I'd like to make sure that we all take some time to remember the many, many millions of individuals who were lost, because that was a lesson that was forgotten in the 1930s. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Squadron. Senator Hamilton.
President, I rise also for the remembrance of Holocaust Day. I was fortunate enough to be in a community with the Lubavitch Jewish community. And our community has healed over the years, from the Crown Heights riots now to a community where everybody works together. And I just want to say, I want to thank Senator Holloman for this resolution. Simon Wiesenthal was mentioned earlier. And we have the Simon Wiesenthal Museum in Los Angeles, and we have the Simon Wiesenthal Museum in New York City. And it's been there for over 15 years, but they're losing their lease. We cannot let this institution, the Simon Wiesenthal Museum, just go away. Unfortunately, the rent was increased 100%, and they're now losing their lease. So I stand here before this body today to say I'm committed to the Simon Wiesenthal Mobile. And this mobile will go throughout the state of New York, and it will show how people and tolerance and how we can live together with diversity in New York State. So I hope my colleagues in the State Senate and in the Assembly will keep the tradition alive of Simon Wiesenthal and the Holocaust remembrance by having the Simon Wiesenthal Tolerance Mobile. I was fortunate enough to go to Israel last year with my friends, and for the first time I was able to see this beautiful country with enemies at all its borders. I went to the Golan Heights, Tel Aviv, and I met so many people who were just genuinely outgoing and loving people. And Tel Aviv is a diverse city. It reminded me of New York. And when I went to the Dead Sea and I went to the Golan Heights and saw ISIS flags on the perimeter, I realized Israel has enemies at all its borders. So when I came back home, but when I was still in Israel, I met young men and women from Crown Heights who are fighting and putting their lives on the line to protect us here in the United States and to protect those in Israel. And I said to myself, knowing these young men and women in my community who are overseas and putting their lives on the line, I could not come back home and not support them and keep them safe. That's why I did not support the Iranian deal, because I said to myself, I must protect these young men and women from Crown Heights who are putting their lives on the line for their community and our community. And when I came home with the Iranian deal, when I protested the Iranian deal, we protested, myself, Senator Simcha Felder, Assemblyman Dov Hykin, to speak out against this Iranian deal, putting Israel in jeopardy. And I saw Holocaust survivors, vibrant people who witnessed horrors that none of us ever witnessed in our lives, still brandishing the tattoos that were put on their arms in the death camps. 600 million Jews died in the death camps. But we must remember, it wasn't Nazi Germany that killed many of the Jews. It was average citizens in other countries who took it upon themselves to allow this atrocity to happen. So I stand today as Jesse Hamilton in a community where when we see a swastika drawn on anybody's house, on any structure, we erase it the same day. We do not tolerate anti-Semitism. We do not tolerate hate in my district. And that's why when I go to the shuls and I speak to young people and I speak to women who are being attacked for their wedding rings, they didn't know who I was. But they always heard my name, Jesse Hamilton. But in Christ, they called me Yeshe. And they said, when I speak out, I said, I'm Jesse Hamilton. He goes, that's Yeshe. Because if you hurt one of us, you hurt all of us. And so today, I just want to say I'm glad to be part of the resolution for the Holocaust Remembrance Day. Thank you so much. Shalom.
Senator Hamilton, thank you. Senator Sanders.
Thank you, Mr. President. I want to thank the sponsor for this resolution. As an African American, I am no stranger to Holocaust, so hearing of Holocaust will always get my attention. I am appalled that the president did not mention the Jewish people when he was speaking. I'm also appalled that he had his Muslim ban on the same day. This does not reflect well on us as a nation. We have to really understand history to understand that we should never do this again. And we always have to look to see when madness starts, and we should get there fast and first to stop it. Had we done this at the beginning of what we now know as World War II, we would have stopped the Nazis with their first Holocaust, which was in Southwest Africa, a colony that they called German Southwest Africa, where the Nazis perfected the Holocaust, where they had their first concentration camps. And 2 million people died there. We have to get wherever the fascists put themselves, we must get there first, fast, and say never again to any of these things. We should never forget, and we should vow as a country, as a community, as people, never again, that an injury to one is an insult to all of us. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator Sanders. Senator Alcantara.
Thank you, Senator Brad Hoyerman, for introducing this resolution. Today, more than ever, it's important to remember why it's so important to talk about the Holocaust and to remember what happened. Not only were 6 million Jews killed, millions of others lost all their property, their home country, got separated from their family and had to start anew. And we have to remember that 6 million people were killed for no other reason but their religion. It's a shame that our current president decided to pass his immigration ban against Muslims on a day that we should be celebrating and remembering the contribution of our Jewish brothers and sisters. I stand here in solidarity with my Jewish brothers and sisters to remember one thing we learned about the Holocaust is that a group of people was able to survive, forgive, and start again. And they promised themselves that they would never sit in silence and let this happen again. Again, thank you, Senator Brad Hoyerman, for standing up, not only commemorating the Holocaust, but also standing up for our immigrant community, our brothers, Muslim and sisters, our Mexican brothers and sisters that are currently under attack. And just to remind everybody, during the Holocaust, the Dominican Republic took over 1,000 Jewish refugees because they had no other place to go. Today is a good opportunity to remember what our president is trying to sell us as keeping us safe could lead us down the wrong path when and it creates a climate, much like happened in Nazi Germany when we start laboring and targeting people because of their religion and their country of origin. We as a people have a commitment to the 6 million Jews that die, never to let anyone in our community be targeted because of their religion or their country of origin. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Hearing no other members wishing to be heard, the question is on the resolution. All in favor signify by saying aye. Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted. Madam Floor Leader.
Senator Hoyleman would like to open up this resolution for co-sponsorship.
Resolution is open for co-sponsorship. If you do not wish to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk. Madam Floor Leader.
Can we now take up resolution number 370 by Senator Prasad? Read the title only and call on Senator Prasad.
Secretary will read.
Legislative resolution number 370 by Senator Prasad, recognizing February 1, 2017 as World Hijab Day.
Senator Prasad.
Thank you, Mr. President. Today, now more than ever, it's a day for us to acknowledge what divides us and what also brings us together. In February 1st, 2013, the first World Hijab Day was celebrated. It was celebrated by a woman named Nazma Khan, who came from Bangladesh, who, because she was wearing a hijab, was always ostracized. She was made fun of. She was called all kinds of different names that she should not have been called. Today, over 190 countries will be celebrating World Hijab Day. Many people do not understand the significance of the world, of a hijab. They see it and say, why are you covering your head? Why are you covering your face? Many of them, many of the people who are wearing a hijab, it's because of their religion. There are not only women who wear a hijab, there are men who do so. It's a sign of modesty when they are wearing it. And so we must acknowledge that hijab, people wearing hijabs should not be ridiculed. You know, there are many forms of hijabs. It's considered a headscarf. It's considered a kerchief covering your head. It's worn coming down the back, covering the neck. There are some that it's covering the face. There's some that's only on the head, not covering the neck. So there are various forms. But in all, it's all people who are expressing their religious belief. When we talk about tolerance, that's one of the times we must, in this time more than ever, accept tolerance. Our president decided to target the Muslim population, the population that today is wearing hijabs. We must all come together and show our tolerance and our acceptance of others' religion and say this should never happen. We should not discriminate against anyone because of their religion, because of their race, because of their ethnic origin. Today, we must show solidarity. And showing solidarity does not mean that you accept every part of someone's religion or every part of what someone does, what someone's ethnic group does. It is showing that you are tolerant. We must all be tolerant. The same way when we sit here, we ask everyone to be tolerant of the decisions that we make, whether we like it or not. It's all about tolerance. Accepting someone wearing a hijab, it's about tolerance. And I encourage my colleagues to accept and to say, we are tolerant. We are here in the great state of New York. We are welcoming, we are accepting, we understand you. So I encourage my colleagues just to remember that. Hijab is expressing who we are. We are all one. Despite whatever differences we have, we are all one. Let's all be tolerant. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Persaud. The question is on the resolution. All in favor signify by saying aye. Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted. Madam Floor Leader.
Senator Persaud would like to open this resolution up for co-sponsorship.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. If you do not wish to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk. Madam Floor Leader.
Can we return to motions and resolutions?
Motions and resolutions.
On page number 9, I offer the following amendments to calendar number 55, Senate print number 1379A, and ask that the bill retain its place on the third reading calendar.
So ordered.
I would like to remind members that Commerce will be meeting immediately following session in room 813 in the LOB.
Madam Floor Leader, I'm sorry, who will be meeting?
Commerce will be meeting immediately following session in room 813 in the LOB.
Commerce will be meeting in room 813 in the LOB.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
I move to adjourn until Monday, February 6th at 3 p.m., intervening days being legislative days.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Monday, February 6th at 3 p.m., intervening days being legislative days.